Okay, here is lesson 11.3, area of regular polygons, all right? This formula here is for the area of equilateral triangles. I want you to memorize this formula. The one thing I do want to point out, because it's square root of 3 times side squared, when you put it in your calculator, you know, 1/4, no problem. When you do radical 3, it opens up a parenthesis. Be sure to close it off before you put in side squared, okay? All right, so memorize this formula. And also, if I don't have any units, I want you to use inches, okay? So first off, let's do a little experiment. Let's check out the new formula. Here's an equilateral triangle, all the sides are 12. You can tell it's equilateral because it's equal angular. Remember, that's also the definition of being regular. So nu is 1/4 root 3 side squared. Make sure you close off that radical with a parenthesis so the side doesn't get plugged into there. All right, that gives me 62.4 inches squared. If we use the old method, remember the old method is 1/2 base times height. Well, I know what the base is, but I don't know the height. If I draw the height in here, remember, it bisects this angle, so this is going to be 30, 60, 90. 30, 60, 90, special right triangle. I don't know if you remember that, but remember the hypotenuse is 2 times the short leg. So the short leg is this section right here. 12 divided by 2 is 6. Then the long leg, which is the height of an equilateral triangle, it's root 3 times bigger. So 6 root 3. All right, now we have all the information we need. So the old one is 1/2. Base, remember the original base, the entire 12, times the height, which is 6 root 3. I'm going to type that on my fancy little calculator, and I also get 62.4 inches squared. All right, so whether you like to use the old method, that's fine, but I just wanted to give you this new formula. So I think it's actually pretty easy. Some people weren't, like, they weren't a huge fan of special right triangles, but you know, this is another way to go about it, right? More tools for your tool chest. All right, so let's look at number 2. I'm going to use the new method still because it's new. Why not? Let's practice. So area, 1/4, root 3, side squared. Be really careful when you have a side that is 4 with a radical, I'm sorry, that has a radical. Because when you square it, remember we square the 4, that gives us 16, and then multiply 16 times 7. That's 16 times 10. So this should actually equal 112. I would suggest using parentheses. Like when I plug this in my calculator, I do 1/4 times root 3, close it off, open a set of parentheses, 4 root 7, now close, so all your parentheses are closed, and square it. And you get 48.5 inches. Alright, if you do it without that and you already figured that out, like kind of like we did with yesterday's video, and you know this is 112, you're going to get the same answer. You can read it or not. All right, let's do some more investigating. All right, the center of a polygon is the center of a circumscribed circle. Here is the center G, okay? That's the center of the polygon, which is also the center of the circle, the circumscribed circle, right? Because there's an inscribed polygon there. All right, the radius of a polygon is the radius of the circumscribed circle. So remember, the radius is from the center to the edge of the circle. But it's really important when you have an inscribed polygon that you go to the vertex, right? There's your radius. That is the radius. Not the radius if you do the center. That's the height of a triangle. Okay, so those are all the radius of the polygon. Here's another vocab word for you that you've never heard of, probably, is the word opossum. So the opossum here, I'm going to draw it. This is the opossum. It's also the height of one of the triangles. That is the opossum. That's what the opossum is. All right, next we're going to talk about central angle. The central angle of a regular polygon, and I don't know why my thing is so tiny, but your paper is much bigger, thank God you have it in front of you. An angle whose vertex is the center and sides containing two consecutive vertices. All right, so the central angle. We divide 360 by the number of sides to find the measure of the central angle. So the central angle is going to be this whole thing here. Let's just figure out what that measure should be here, right? Because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. So 360 divided by 5 will give us the measure of the central angle. 360 divided by 5 is 72. 72 degrees. So the measure of angle CBA is 72 degrees. The measure of angle CBD, is half of that, right? Because this opossum bisects the angle up there. So that would be 72 divided by 2, which is 36 degrees. We're going to need that because we're actually going to do a little bit of something. All right, but that's how you find the central angle. 360 divided by the number of sides. And also make sure that you understand that the altitude for the opossum bisects the central angle. All right, let's put our stuff to business. All right, here is another formula, one of many to come. All right, this formula, oh, I can't make it bigger. Sorry, guys, you have it on your paper. It is 1/2. This is the area of this regular polygon. 1/2 times the opossum times the perimeter. That's what the big P is. The big P stands for perimeter. The little A stands for opossum. You just multiply those together. Okay, this is, I have my little things over here. We're going to figure this out. The central angle, first off, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 360 divided by 5. We just did that. We know that's 72 degrees. Okay? I'm going to have to split that so that I can just focus on this part of this triangle so I can find out what the opossum is. So half of 72 is 36. Okay? I want to know the opossum. This is the opossum right here. It is adjacent to the measure. I'm going to write Sokotoa down here in case you forgot. All right, I have the hypotenuse. Remember, this is perpendicular to the base. It's the altitude. So I have the hypotenuse. I'm looking for adjacent. Adjacent hypotenuse is cosine. I'm going to use cosine because I have the, I have the hypotenuse. So cosine of 36 degrees is equal to x over 3, right? Adjacent over hypotenuse. Now we just multiply. X equals 3 times cosine of 36. That is how we're going to get the opossum. And round to the nearest tenth. And it's going to give us 2.4. Beautiful. Let's use trig functions again to find the opposite side because I need to know what this is. Now this is only half of one side of the inscribed polygon. Alright? So this is opposite of the angle. Opposite hypotenuse is sine. Sine of 36 equals x over 3. Now it's not always that you're going to use sine, but because we have the hypotenuse, that's obviously sine and cosine are going to be what's going to get us what we need. All right. So again, just like we did because the variables in the numerator, we're going to multiply x equals 3 times sine of 36, that gives us 1.8, right? 1.8 is only half of the side. I want the entire side. The entire side is 1.8 times 2. So 1.8 times 2 is 3 centimeters. Alright, cool. Okay, that's kind of a hard part, I feel like, man. Look at that, we just completed that part. So now, the perimeter of this, right, we know it has 5 sides. One of the sides is 3.6, so 3.6 times, I need to get the colors here. So 3.6 times 5, is 18. So the perimeter is 18. Now the area. I just gave you the formula for area. So the area is 1 half times the opossum, which is 2.4, times the perimeter, 18. Round to the nearest tenth, and we got inches in here, so we're happy with that. And when I plug it in my fancy little calculator, I get 21.6 inches. Okay. You are going to have to do all of these steps to find the area. I'm sorry, that's just the way it's going to be. We're going to do some more practice, and hopefully you feel a little more confident when you do that. Even though we're like, what? This is so weird. Remember, if I go too fast, you can pause, you can rewind, you can watch this over and over again. Very exciting. All right, first up, we got a square here. What? Central angle, 360 divided by 4, it gives us 90 degrees. I only want half of that, right? The central angle would be like if I had this side here. I only want half of that. That's actually 45 degrees. All right, the opossum is already given. It's 3 root 2. I am okay if you want to use the decimal version, which is 4.2 inches, of course. One side. I do not have one side of my inscribed square, so I'm going to have to use some sort of trig function to find that. So, I don't know if you realize this, but this is a 45 degree side. That's what I'm saying. But anyway, let's do circular angles if I can get that. Alright, so I'm looking for half of the one side. It is opposite of the angle. I can either use this side, which looks terrible, or I can use the hypotenuse, which is just 6, and that seems better. So opposite hypotenuse would be sine. So sine of 45 degrees is equal to opposite over hypotenuse, x equals 6 times sine of 45, and that gives us... degrees is 4.2, which is what we already defined. Let's multiply that times 2, because remember that's only half of the one side. That gives us 8.4 inches. And if you don't see a unit, just use inches, just so you get in the habit of using units for the measures. Alright, the perimeter of the square is literally taking that 8.4 times 4. Gives us the perimeter, which is, I got 33.9, but it could be wrong. 8.4 times 4, 33.6. So you would get a different answer if you rounded versus using the radical, but it's not too far. 33.6. If you did 3 root 2 times 2, which is 6 root 2, I guess I should write that here. 4. 6 root 2. This is more exact because I didn't know the number. Okay, and if I took 4 times 6 root 2, that would give me 33.9. So, I wrote 33.9, but what did I get last time? 33.6. So either way, let me just move this over here. So if we use 8.4, we get 33.6. If we use 6 root 2, this is 33
I'm fine with that. We're going to be, you know, make sure you're showing all your work, but understand what you're using, trying to figure that out and your stuff. Thank you. Definitely not going to work.
All right, area 1/2 times the apothem. All right, let's do this two ways. Let's use the radical form and just compare. Times the perimeter. You know, we'll use a perimeter that's more exact, 33.9, 4, 6 root 2. And let's find the area here. Okay, and then we'll do it with the other way just to show you guys the difference. Okay, so 1/2 times 3 root 2 times 6 root 2. That feels okay. Crazy number, man. I forgot to multiply that times 4. I'm sorry. Oh my gosh. What is going on? I already deleted one video. I'm not starting over again. Sorry. But none of this is inside. It's a square. It has 4 sides. 4 times 4 is 6. I mean, 4 times 6 is 24. Root 2. I'm going to go back and fix it in my calculator. Instead of 6, I have 24 square root 2. And that gives me even 72. If I just use my decimal, area equals 1/2, let's see, the apothem is 4.2, times the perimeter, 33.6, what does that give us? 1/2 times 4.2 times 33.6, 70.56, which makes it 70.6, which is quite a difference, isn't it? Ooh, that's crazy. 70.6. Thank you. Good. So that's a new mark. I'm interested. Alright, what I'm going to suggest is if you're given the apothem, use it. Because that's a pretty big difference here. 70.6 and 72, that's a pretty big difference. So if I just played around with my calculator, and if I use the apothem, which was given 3 root 2, and then I use this decimal here, which is 4 times 6 root 2, just in the calculator, 33.9, that gives me 71.94, which is a lot closer to 72 than 70.6. So if you're given the apothem, use it. I don't care if it has a radical in it. All right, here we go. Central angle. Oh my gosh, how many sides does it have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is octagon. All right, so central angle is 360 divided by 8. That gives us 45. Remember, that's the whole angle here. I only want half of the central angle. So half of 45 is 22.5 degrees. They gave us the hypotenuse. That is not the apothem. I need this line. I need that BB, okay? That is the apothem. So that is adjacent. I have hypotenuse. Here's my SOHCAHTOA. All right, adjacent hypotenuse. That gives us cosine. The cosine of 22.5 is equal to x over 7. 7 times cosine 22.5 is how we're going to find x. Let me do it. 7 times cosine 22.5. 6.5 is what I get. About. Let me just figure to get that number. 6.5. We just found the apothem. Cool. One side. That's opposite. Remember, but we're only finding half of the one side, so whatever we get, we want to multiply by 2. So, opposite a hypotenuse is going to be sine. Sine of 22.5 equals x over 7. Seven sine 22.5. I get 2.67, or just round up 2.7. Multiply that times 2. 2.7 times 2 is 5.4. I'm not really good at inches. I'll label mine and find the finale answer. All right, we already know it has 8 sides. One side 5.4, so 5.4 times 8 gives us 43.4. Now we're ready to plug and tug. Area equals 1/2 times the apothem, 6.5 times the perimeter, 43.2. I'll get on my fancy little calculator and I get 140.4 inches squared. Boom, done. Love it. So nice. All right, here is some craziness. I know on your thing I just have area of a triangle, but I need to find out a lot of information for the whole other side. Okay, so to find the one side, we're going to kind of do what we were doing before. We are going to do, first off, it's a triangle, so we're going to find the central angle. 360 divided by 3 is 60. Alright? Now, if I were to draw a little thing here, so this whole thing would be 60, that means this is 30. This is the hypotenuse. As weird as it looks, I know none of my pictures are drawn to scale, but it's a special right triangle again. So, if the hypotenuse is 8, I mean, you can use trig, you can realize that it's a special right triangle and know that the short leg is half of that, which is 4. So the apothem is 4. One side, well, I can find out half a side. This is the long leg. So that would be 4√3. And the whole thing would just be 8√3. That's one side. If you wanted to use trig, you totally can do it, but I know it's kind of weird. You're going to kind of turn it around. The perimeter, 8√3 times 4. Well, 8√3, I guess, is really 13 from there. Perimeter, 3 times 13.8 would be 41.4. And then we can plug it into our formula. 1/2 times the apothem times the perimeter gives us the area of 1/2 times 4 times 41.4. 82.8 inches squared. Alright, that's how we do it. Alright, that's not so bad. I hope. Alright, special right triangles. Maybe, you know, YouTube a little video on that to give yourself a refresher. All right, one more example before we're done. First off, let's find the central angle. So it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sides. 360 divided by 6. All right, hold on. I just realized I made a mistake. So 360 divided by 6 is 60. That's the central angle here. And we just did that triangle on the last slide, and I messed that up. The central angle is not 60. It's 120. And half of 120 is 60. So this is not 30. Oh my God, this is crazy. So this angle is actually half of 120, which is 60 degrees. And so that makes this guy up here 30 degrees. And so this is still a short leg, and the other math is still right. I just had the central angle wrong. I apologize for that, and hopefully you noticed that before, and you're not screaming at the video. Sorry about that. It happens. We're all human. We all make mistakes. Okay. So the apothem, remember, so the central angle, is this whole part. I need half that. because I want to find a new constant. So half of 60 is 30. So that makes this the shortest.
So you can use SOHCAHTOA if you want to. I am a big fan of special right triangles, but that's just me, okay?
So half of 18 is 9. And then remember the third being 6. All right, and the opossum is actually root 3 times the short leg. So the opossum is going to be 9 root 3. All right, we already just discovered that one size 18. 18 times 6 is 108 inches area. One half times the opossum, 9 root 3, make sure you close off that parenthesis, times 108. I plug it in my fancy little calculator, and I get 841.8 inches. All right. Sorry if you have to watch the video again, but it is what it is. That's how we have to do it. So special right triangles or use SOHCAHTOA, whatever you got to do. There is a worksheet I gave you that goes along with the homework. Make sure you're finding all of these things. So the ones and here is your homework for tonight. It is not 61. I think it's like 59. I'm losing track. It doesn't even matter. It's 59. Maybe it's 60, because I think I was almost one wrong. So please draw pictures from the book. Do not draw in the book. So 1 to 9, then number 14, 19, 20, 23, and 24. Let me know if you have any questions, and have a great day. Bye.